In this video, I show how to do an SQL lookup in Interform NG. Here is the complete list of the things that I will go through. So we'll need to place a JDBC driver if we're going to access a database on another machine. We need to restart the processor service if we have added a JDBC driver. Create an extent file with the actual SQL statement. And then we need to refer to that in our workflow, run it without any action, and then we will have a transformed XML file with the additional SQL data, and that we can use as the basis of our design. And then finally, we can add our new design, our new template in the workflow, including the information we added through SQL. So in the workflow, you need to set up a condition that match your input XML file. And here for the transform style sheet, you now refer to the name of your extent file that should be placed in resources/transform or a subdirectory. This extent file could look like this. So you have first a reference to the JDBC driver, the machine that you're going to use for the lookup, ID and password, the path in the XML where we're going to grab information. And this has actually been built for the demo XML file of Interform NG. So if we take a look at that, you can see here we have a 4-digit number placed inside of root document. So we're going to retrieve that number and do a lookup in a database. This database for this small demo example looks like this. So we have a 4-digit number matching the XML contents, and then we want to add text 1 and text 2 fields into the new XML. For the actual SQL expression in our extent file, we type it like this. So we have a question mark for the parameters that we grab from the input XML and replace for values here in the SQL lookup. So here for the root document means that this document, which is a field in our input XML, is actually going to be replacing this question mark. You could have additional parameters and additional question marks, and they are substituted in the sequence that you see here on the parameter list. The output XML file looks like this. So we have here in the bottom some extra additional SQL data for each of the three documents that we have here in our demo XML file. Now we have this output XML. You can copy that from the transform box directory, put it into the resources/documents, and then use that as a basis of your design. And then you can go back to the workflow and add here as an action a reference to your design.